You're such a good writer. Sorry. Let's be seriously overreacting. You're not a good writer at all. I'll say it's annoying what I'm doing. I'm just making it. Well, maybe that's why. Because I have no idea what I like either. So, I don't know if that's a good thing or a bad thing. I'm not really sure. Please. Jerry's opinion has to be a little more constructive than this. Maybe even Natsuki's. Are you sure you don't like it just because I wrote it? Eh? Well, I'm sure that's part of it. I think I understand you better than a lot of other people do. So when I read your poem, it's not just a poem. It's a real watch poem. Okay. That makes it feel extra special. I can feel your feelings in it. Jerry hugs the sheet against your chest. You okay? Okay, mate? You're so weird, Sarah. I'm really happy. Just that you were the one. This reminds me of how you're really part of the club now. I can move my mic closer. My voice is pretty quiet. Not to mention the fact that I'm standing in front of you in the club room. Well, of course. Not really into it yet, but that doesn't mean I'll break my promise. See? I said, just like I said before, girl watch. Deep down, you're not selfish at all, you know. Try new things like this for other people. That's something that only really good people do. Thanks, Yori. I'm not sure Siri sees the full picture of my motive here. Then again, I can't deny that she's part of the reason I joined. No. No. Get down. Get down. Knowing how much this means to her and all. Yeah. And I'm gonna make sure that you have lots of fun here, okay? So I'm probably gonna blur that thing out, to give that person privacy. That'll be my way of thinking. Oh, thank you. Alright. I'm going to hold you to that then. Yay! Now you'll read my poem too, right? Don't worry. I'm really bad at this. We'll see about that. We will see.
Dear sunshine, the way you glow through my blinds in the morning, it makes me feel like you missed me. Kissing my forehead to help me out of bed, making me rub the sleepy from my eyes. Are you asking me to come out and play? Are you trusting me to wish away a rainy day? I look above, the sky is blue. It's a secret, but I trust you too. If it wasn't for you, I could sleep forever. But I'm not mad.
I want breakfast.
Seriously. You had like a good rhyme scheme going and then I want breakfast. Seriously. How do I? Oh, there we go. Jerry. This is just a guess, but you wait until this morning to write this. No. Ahaha. Crash later, baby. Just a little bit. And answer just a little bit to a yes or no question.
I do not. There is no time. Yes or no.
I forgot to do it last night. Were you playing some, I don't know, some type of video game last night? Hint, hint! Well, at least that makes me feel a little bit better about myself. Don't be mean. I still tried my best. Yeah. I didn't mean to say that it was a bad poem. It came out nice, or how should I put it? It sounded just like you. Really? Yeah. Especially that last time. I made eggs and toast. Even though you were late to school. It's bad to skip breakfast. I get all cranky. Well, I guess there's no point in arguing. Anyway, thanks for showing me. This is so much fun. Monique is the best. Did you say Monique? I think it's Monica. Yeah. Next time, I won't forget. I'm gonna write the best poem ever. Well, I guess I'll look forward to it. Should I, do it to Natsuki first? Oh, man. It's Natsuki. Okay. Well, let's get... Start with the things I don't like. First of all, Natsuki reads my poem. Never mind. I don't feel like giving you my opinion. What's the point of sharing in the first place? Or with this one, I could have been doing other things. I could have played some... what could I have done? I could have watched some YouTube videos. I could have played some... You guys are probably going to think I'm going to say Minecraft. But I could have played some... Paladins. TF2. Portal 2. I don't think I have any other games with the 2 in them. But I could have done... Oh, I could have played some Super Mario Bros. 2. I could have done all that. In fact, remember, I said I wanted to read your poems. That's what I had in mind when writing this. I want to help you feel comfortable enough to share yours. Like Monica said... I think I've been calling her Monika this whole time. That's embarrassing. Well, I'd be more comfortable sharing my poem if yours was really bad. So I guess you'll be comfortable sharing your poem. Yeah, that clip right there. Just roasted myself right there. Yeah, why? We're supposed to show me the dumb poem, and we go, huh, well, it's not that great. Let me show you what real literature looks like. And you went and ruined it. I hope you're happy. I'm not happy? Should I be happy? In other words, they're saying you liked it. Erk. I think he's... Jordan gets caught in her throat. You don't understand anything, do you? I really told you. You don't have to go announcing it to the world. Like you're all self-important. Well, I know how to finish a game 100%. You need to get all the achievements in the Lego games that I completed. One of them I got all achievements. The other thing you need to do is get all stars. All three, star coins, or whatever it's called in Mario. Pretty sure you never actually said that. I said that mostly myself. Zuki must really hate me or something. I forgot it's a win or loss. In any case, you'll need to show me yours, right? Fine, I guess. Only because Monica will make me. Okay.
Eagles can fly, monkeys can climb, crickets can leap, horses can race, owls can seek, cheetahs can run, eagles can fly, people can try.
Well, that's about it. Why do all these poems have just a... The last line just... Adds like nothing, like no rhyme scheme at all. Doesn't really go with the rest of the poem. Well, do I press space or something? Oh, there we go. Right. No. Where are you red? Right here. I don't know how to skip the poem. I'm left clicking, I'm right clicking, I'm middle clicking, and space bar. Pressing the. I don't know how I can play the other one. Do you press escape? Nope. Turn. There we go. I was told to check the game files. Something weird happened. Oh, there we go. Yeah. Told you you weren't gonna like it. I like it. It was nice. It was special. Different. But just be honest, I am. Why are you so convinced that I wouldn't like it? Well, because everyone in high school thinks that writing has to be all sophisticated and stuff. So people don't even take my writing seriously. Just rub my, knock my headset into my mic. I need to move my mic into it. There we go. Well, isn't that the point of poems for people to express themselves? Writing style wouldn't make your message any less valid. Validation right there. I think. Yes, exactly. I like when it's easy to read, but it hits you hard. Like in this poem, sing one around you. Do great things should be really disheartening. So I decided to write about it. Yeah, that's pretty reasonable. I understand. But the other nice thing I do is simply writing. And that puts more weight on the word play. Like I set a rhyme at the end, but then I make it full circle. Seriously. Did everybody seriously do that? Oh, man. I see what... I think Yuri is the last version. Let's see what she writes. See if she did the same thing. I'll spring up the feeling in the last time. So you did. I guess more went into that than I realized. That's what it means to be a pro. Well... haven't subscribed yet, there's a channel called The Pros. It's it's a group channel. It's pretty good. I'm glad you learned something. Didn't expect that from the youngest one here. Actually. Okay, so I know I'm not the youngest. That's cool. Yeah, guess not. Said to humor her with my last. The last time I didn't know what the old everyone is, but to be so proud that I won't take away from her. Oopsie. I guess I wasn't supposed to actually know the age or something. I don't know. Where is the last person? Oh, there we go. Just kidding. Yeah, I thought this was Yuri. No. I didn't think this was Yuri. I thought Yuri was the one with green eyes, but no. Here starts the poem. I'm gonna pass this. More than enough time for finish reading. Sorry. I forgot to start speaking. Sign, don't force yourself. I'm not. I just need to put my thoughts into words. Hold on. Ow. My mic just hit me in the neck. Bad mic. Okay. It's your first time writing a poem, right? Yeah. Why do you ask? You're good. Actually, I think my volume is down. Is it? No. Why do you ask? I'm just making sure. I guess that might be after reading through it. So it's that bad. No. The distraction voice. I'm so sorry. When you see the red right here. Reverse her face and her hands. Her hands are right here. I don't know how accurate the animation is. I couldn't help but notice that there were so much, and we really haven't gone anywhere. And it took Yuri a while to get used to new people. Besides, I didn't really notice. What were you saying? Right, it's just that there are specific writing habits that are usually typical of new writers, and having been through that myself, I kind of learned to pick up on them. I think the most stop hitting the mic. Okay. the most noticeable thing I recognize in new writers is that they try to make their style very deliberate. In other words, they tend to pick a writing style separate from the topic matter, and they form fit the two together. And then the result is that both the style and the expressiveness are weakened. Once Yuri ends her train of thought, it's as if her demeanor totally changes. Her stammering is completely gone, and she sounds like an expert. Of course, that's not something you can be blamed for. There's so many different skills and techniques that go into writing even a simple poem. Not just finding them and building them, but getting them to work together is probably the most challenging part. It might take you some time, but it all comes with practice, and learning by example, and trying new things. Also, I hope that everyone else in the club gives you valuable feedback. But you can be a little biased, a little bit biased, though.
Biased? How?
Never mind. I shouldn't be talking to people like that. Sorry. It's fine. I'm not sure if Yuri is apologizing to herself, to me, or Jinzuki. Do you mind if I read your poem now? Please do. I'd love to share my thought process behind it. He responds dreamily, as if that's a rare opportunity for her. Which itself is kind of funny. After all, isn't it supposed to be a literature club?
Ghosts in the light. Ghosts under the light. The trendles of my hair illuminate beneath the amber glow. Bathing. It must be this one, the last remaining streetlight that withstood the rest of the test of time. The last yet to be replaced by the sickening blue-green hue of the future. I bathe, calm, breathing air of the present, but living in the past. Light flickens. I flicken back.
Okay, now that one was actually rhyming. So, I think she got the idea. Oh man, not this again. I don't know how to skip poems. Just pressing the space bar and shaking my whole computer. I don't even know what I pressed. What did I do? What did I do? No. Well, this is very exciting then, I guess. Really should have paid attention to what I was doing in the last two poems. Stretching. There we go. Get back into recording position. Okay, there we go. I'm so sorry. It's such a terrible handwriting. I can't really hear. I can't really read curses, so. Yeah. Not terrible handwriting, too, so. Brofist. The Brofist. What? I wasn't thinking that at all. But it took me a long time to read. As I said before, I can't really read cursive, so yeah, that's a problem. just don't read script very often. Yeah. I think this is what cursive is. Actually, I think your handwriting is pretty good. Yeah?
That's a relief.
Awesome. I like the poem. Even though it was short, it was really descriptive. And it wasn't the thing with the other two poems, where the last one doesn't rhyme. That's so good that this one rhymed. So good. It wasn't too short. You wrote long poems. I don't know. I'm really glad you liked it. I'll be honest. Since our first time sharing, I wanted to write something a little more mild. Things are easy to digest, I suppose. Are you into ghosts, Yuri? Actually, the story isn't about a ghost at all, real watch.
Really?
Must have totally missed the point. I suppose you did only glance over it, after all. I haven't played this in like a month. Well, remember the poets often express their own thoughts, feelings, and experiences in their work. They usually do more than tell a simple story or paint a picture. In that case, perhaps the subject of the poem is only being symbolically compared to a ghost, lingering in her last remaining place, a comfort unable to let go of the past, and seem to be left with nothing. It's a lot more solemn put in that way. I haven't even thought of that. That's impressive. It's nothing really. Well, it makes me happy that you think that. Just remember that it won't be long before you pick up on these things too. Yeah, maybe you're right.
I guess I'll have to keep trying. I'm counting on you.
Phew. I guess it's everyone. I guess around the room. That was a little more stressful than I anticipated. And it's as if everyone is judging me for my mediocre writing abilities.
Stop hitting my mic. That's it. The mic is your friend. The mic is a buddy. You guys are a team. You should do videos together. You guys are a team.
Yeah, they're just being nice. There's no way my phones can't stand up to this. Up to theirs. This is a wish club, girl. I said. I guess that's what I ended up getting myself into, though. I cross the room, Siri and Monica are happily chatting. My eyes land on Yuri and the Suki. They gingerly exchange sheets of paper, sharing their respective poems. They read in tandem. I watch each of their expressions change, and Suki's eyebrows furrow in frustration, while Yuri smiles sadly. Did he say something? Oh, it's not. Suki dismissively returns to the poem to the desk to one hand. I guess you could say it's fancy. Ah, thanks. It's just cute.
Cute?
Oh, wait. I think last time, we were told to not call her cute. I think she got mad. So, Yuri, I don't think that was a good idea. You completely miss the symbolism or something. It's clear about the feeling of holding up. How can that be cute? I know that. This meant language, I guess. I was trying to say something nice. You have to try that hard to come up with something nice to say. Thanks, but it really didn't come out nice at all. Wow. Well, I have a couple suggestions. Her suggestions, it would ask someone who actually liked it. She has an attitude. Which people did, by the way. Siri liked it. I watched it too. So based on that, that's in the suitcase. Never mind. So
based on the obligations of Christmas. First of all, my mic. Excuse me? I appreciate the offer, but it's been a long time establishing my rights. I don't expect it to change anytime soon, unless, of course, I come across something particularly inspiring, which I haven't yet. And Roblox, like, my poem too, you know. He even told me he was impressed by it. He suddenly stands up. Oh, I didn't realize you were so invested in trying to impress our new member, Yuri. Yeah, that's not what I, you're just, Yuri stands up as well. Maybe you're just jealous of Roblox, appreciates my advice. Yuri, then, who appreciates yours?
How do you know he didn't appreciate my professor? And you're that full of yourself?
No. If I was full of myself, I would deliberately go out of my way to make everything I do overly cutesy. Everyone okay? Well, you know what? Wasn't the one. I'm just gonna let you guys read this, because it's a really awkward one. Ziki. Ziki, that's a little. That does involve you. I'm only finding guys. Emily Bushgirls, they noticed I was standing there. Girl watch, she's trying to make me look bad. That's not true. She started it. Recover herself. So, I think this is the one thing that he was standing there. He was saying. So, let me go.
How do you get into the properties, I think?
General... Like, reading... Security... Administrations...
I don't know what... by checking on files. I'm not actually sure.
Oh, wait, let's see.
She could get over herself and learn to appreciate that simple writing is more effective.
And this would have happened in the first place. What's the point of making the poems all convoluted for no reason? The meaning should jump out at the reader, not force them to have to figure out. Let me explain to her in a watch. Wait, this is the real reason why so many deep and expressive words in our language. Religion, they complex feelings and meaning that most effectively. One of them is not only unnecessary language, but also a waste. You don't understand that. Right, girl watch? Mike?
My head is not that as close to the mic, so you guys can hear me, but my headset is huge. So, maybe not huge, but it's pretty big. So, if I lean down, my headset usually, it's the mic. I'm sorry. Damn, man, not again. That's my mic's fault.
Into this in the first place. It's not like I know anything about writing.
Whomever I agree with, they probably think more highly of me.
Of course, that's going to be. Well, I'm sorry. This is gonna be a cliffhanger. I'm sorry. Wait. Never mind, I can't say it.
Help me, Mizuki. Mizuki glares at me, jarring up any words I have in my mouth. Instead, I turn to Yuri. Yuri? Yuri's expression is so defenseless. I can't bring myself to it and say anything to her. Yuri? Huh? Yeah. I'm not saying anything Yuri uncomfortable. How can the two of you keep fighting when you know you're making your friend feel like this? Watch. Well, that's her problem. This isn't about her. I agree. It's unfair to others to inject their own feelings into our conflict. Yeah, unless Sayori wants to tell Yuri what a stuck-up jerk she is being. She would never. And your immaturity that makes her upset in the first place. Excuse me? I look like Joseph. Oh, no. Is this going to be a three-way fight? Oh, that's exactly why. Exactly why nobody likes. Stop. Zuki, Yuri, you guys are my friends. I just want everyone to get along and be happy. Friends are wonderful people, and I love them because of their differences. Zuki's poems, they're amazing because they give up. They give you so many feelings with just a few words. And Yuri's poems are amazing because they paint beautiful pictures in your head. Everyone's so talented. So why are we fighting? Because, well, also, Mizuki's cute. There's nothing wrong with that. And Yuri. The guy who requested this game. Why didn't you warn me about this? Yuri stands triumphantly. Monica stands behind her with a bewildered expression. I'll make some tea. Yuri rushes off. He sits down with a blank expression on his face, staring at nothing. So, this is why Yuri is vice president. I was searching Monica. She nods in return. To be honest, I can come off as a good leader, and I can organize things, but not very good with people. I can even bring myself to interject. President, that's kind of embarrassing to me. Huh. Nah. It's not like I could blame you. I wasn't able to say anything either. Well, I guess I just mean Siri is amazing in her own ways, essentially. We could say that. Might be a darehead, but sometimes it's weirdly suspicious that she knows exactly what she's doing. I see. Stop doing the Sonic thing. Her legs are still there, so I guess she's not doing the Sonic thing. Her legs would be like here and here. Take care of yourself. Take care of her, okay? I would hate to see her get herself hurt. That makes two of us. You can count on me. Monica smiles sweetly at me, causing my stomach to knot. Such a genuine person really does make a good present, regardless of what she says. If only I get the chance to talk to her a little more. Thank you guys for watching. Remember to like, subscribe, and I'll see you guys in the next video. Bye.